Hi, everyone. My name is Deborah Chen, and I'm a program manager on the Azure Cosmos DB team. Today, I'm going to be telling you about how you can estimate and measure the RUs for your Cosmos DB workload. In Cosmos DB, when you're starting out a new project, estimating the right amount of RUs or request units for your workload is one of the most important decisions you can make that affect both the cost and performance of what you eventually end up building. We've made it super easy for you to do this with our new RU calculator, where you just tell us some details about our workload, maybe even give us some sample data, and we'll tell you exactly how many RUs we think that you should provision. So here's the tool here. You can find it at cosmos.azure.com/capacity-calculator. And we have two modes. We have a basic mode and a more advanced mode. So if you're just starting out evaluating whether you should choose Cosmos DB for your project, you can set simple settings like the number of regions I might want. If I have a globally distributed workload, I might have up to multiple regions here. We support up to 54 regions. If you have one region, you can just leave it there for now. Whether you want the ability to read and write from every region or just read and write from just one, just be able to write from one region. You can tune that on and off here. These all will impact the cost. You can also give us a high-level ballpark estimate of the total data you have. So let's say I know I have, 50 GB of data. The size of my items, 1 KB, is a pretty good size for a small document, so let's leave it there. As well as, most importantly, the nature of my workload. How many reads and writes per second will I have? So suppose I know I have a pretty read-heavy workload where every second I have 1,000 reads or requests coming to access a piece of data in my database. And let's say writes are less frequent, so I'll just have 100 per second. So with all these parameters filled in, I can calculate, and now Cosmos DB tells me two important things. First, it estimates the amount of storage costs I'll need, so 50 GB, that'll be around $1,250 USD, and it also tells me the amount of throughput required for the workload. So if I know I have this many reads per second and each read will cost a certain amount of RU, we actually do the multiplication for you. So we tell you you'll need this many RUs for reads, this for writes, and at the end of the day, if you provision around this many, you should be in a good starting point for your workload. And finally, we give you a cost estimate as well. Now, this is great if you're just starting out and want a very high-level estimate, but if you're really starting to do the proof of concept and development of your workload, there's actually a lot of other settings you can tune in Cosmos DB that further impact both the performance as well as the cost. Moreover, they can actually help you optimize the cost a lot. So that's why we have this more advanced version of our calculator, which you can find by signing in. After you sign in, you'll see a very similar view, but there's a lot more settings to play around with. So here, in addition to the ones we had before, like read-ins and writes, you can tune things like consistency level. This will impact the cost of writes, but we'll leave things by the default for now. But if I need a stronger consistency or weaker consistency, you can play around with these parameters and see how it impacts the eventual estimate. Here's the three most important things you can find here. One is indexing policy. You can decide, by default, Cosmos DB indexes everything, but let's say I have a very simple key value workload where I actually don't need that level of indexing. I can decide to turn indexing off or leave it to index everything and see how that impacts the write RUs, which if you need fewer write RUs, then your cost can be lower. Right? So you can do things like turn off indexing on and off or even put in a custom indexing policy. Okay. You can also do things like upload a sample item that's actually from your workload. So if you don't set it, you can say how big my document is. But the nice thing is if you upload a sample document, so here I have one, let's say I have a product review. Here is just what it looks like here. That's a bunch of properties. Hit calculate, we actually do a test read and test write of this document against the real Cosmos DB collection. So we'll know exactly how many RUs it costs, so it gives you a much more accurate estimate. So let's say I put in my product review. Let's say again, I have 1,000 reads per second, 100 writes per second, calculate. Okay, and again, I get the same view. I see the number of RUs for reads, writes, as well as storage. One other really nice feature here is that we can also estimate the amount of cost savings you would get if you actually tuned your provisioned RUs up and down. So in Cosmos DB, you can always scale the RUs up and down programmatically, either with the SDK, CLI, Azure Function, whatever tool you want to use. And by lowering the RU when you don't need it, you can actually save a lot on cost. So we actually let you see that here. If you have a workload that's very variable, where suppose for some times in the day you have very high throughput required, and then for other times you have a lot lower throughput required, you can set it to variable and say, you know, at 25% of the time I'm going to be running at peak, I'm going to have, let's say, you know, 1,000 reads per second, 500 writes per second. But then off peak, I actually have very small workload. Maybe I have 10 reads and, you know, 10 writes per second, which is almost negligible, right? So here, if I recalculate again, I can see that it's estimating that I can actually save quite a bit on cost just if I assume I tune my RUs up and down to meet, tune it up when I have my peak workload and tune it down when I have my off-peak workload. So with this capacity calculator, you can get a really great view of not only the amount of RUs that you should try to estimate for your workload, but you can also get a sense of some of the advanced parameters you can tune to further save on cost. So that's at the beginning of the workload. But what if you're already running in production or you're doing a POC and you just want to see what is the real-time RU consumption I actually have against my my Cosmos DB workload? The great news is we have this feature called Diagnostic Logs that's built into Cosmos DB. And if you enable it, which you can do on the diagnostic settings here, if you enable these features, we will actually collect a bunch of telemetry from Cosmos DB, emit it to your choice of destination. So it could be storage account, event hub, or log analytics. And once you're there, these are very real time. They, I think the data will get transferred there in 5 minutes or less, so it's very quick. You can actually report out on how many RUs you're consuming in your real workload with a simple with this query language here. So here I have a query that I am filtering to see for a particular collection. I ran some operations again this earlier, so I know there's going to be requests. I can count the consumed RUs per second, so I'm just summing this request charge. So we report every operation, what it was, what the resource was, how many RUs it consumed, and we'll just bin it by 1 second. So this means for every second, I can see my effective RU consumption. So let's run the query. And I have a pretty heavy workload going on. I'm importing a bunch of data. Oops. So let's run this query. I have a pretty heavy workload. I'm importing a bunch of data. And you can see at each second, this is how many RUs I consumed on my workload. So I can even use this nifty graph here and see. This is per second, so this is actually a very short amount of time. But I can see if I want maybe even just the last hour chart. I can see, you know, for the most part, I'm hovering around 96,000 RUs at my peak, but, you know, maybe my average is more around 50,000 RUs. So this gives me a sense of what my RUs actually are in production. So if I want, I can go on to my collection itself, and let's say I have any collection here. I can go to scale and settings, and I can change this throughput up and down or programmatically to better tune to meet the workload needs. In general, you'll have the best cost savings if you know, you don't want to be under-provisioned or over-provisioned. So figure out what you're running at and then try to set it to a number that you're comfortable with to not be either over-provisioned or under-provisioned. All right. So thanks all for watching today. We've seen how you can both estimate the amount of RUs at the beginning of the workload with our capacity calculator, as well as how to measure the RU consumption real time on a real production or a proof of concept workload using diagnostic logs. Thanks so much. And if you have any other questions or want to learn more about Cosmos DB, check out aka.ms/CosmosDB workshop.